So, in last video, we have discussed expansion of solids on heating. That is thermal expansion of solids. I told expansion of liquid calculation is similar to that of solids. That is, I told, whenever liquids are heated, they get expand. And how much they expand is calculated using the formulas same as that of solids. And we have solved few problems also. And today, let us discuss anomalous expansion of water. You know, water is a liquid. And we have seen that whenever we heat substance, most of the substances get expand on heating. And the substances get cooled on, means contract on cooling. But what happens to this water? It is found that, see, whenever temperature, as the temperature increases, here it is found that when we take the temperature increase, means heated, whenever we heat a body, temperature increases. Then from 0 degree Celsius to 4 degree Celsius. From 0 degree Celsius to 4 degree Celsius. See here, volume of water. You know, most of the substances on heating, the volume increases. But in case of water, from 0 degree to 4 degree Celsius, volume of water decreases. At the same time, if I increase the temperature above 4 degree Celsius, for temperature above 4 degree Celsius, when we increase, same volume as like other substances, volume goes on increases. But you know, whenever substance is heated or cold, their volume changes but mass remains same. Then you know, mass is equal to density into volume. As you know, density is equal to mass by volume. Mass remains same. As volume changes, density also changes. So we know the density. So as volume decreases, density increases. For above 4 degrees Celsius, as temperature increases, volume increases. As a result, density decreases. Hi. When we draw the graph of volume of water versus temperature and density of water versus temperature, let us see what happens. See, here volume of water per unit mass, here it is temperature. It is 0 degree Celsius. As I told, for 0 to 4 degree Celsius, volume decreases. Then goes on increases. Means at some temperature here, at 4 degree Celsius, volume is minimum. Volume is minimum. Okay. Similarly, when I draw the graph of density of water versus temperature, density versus temperature. As you know, from 0 to 4 degree density goes on increases, then goes on decreases. Means here is 4 degree Celsius, it is once again 0 degree Celsius. So this is the graph of volume versus temperature. It is a graph of density versus temperature for water. So from this graph, it is clear that volume is minimum at 4 degree Celsius and density is maximum at 4 degree Celsius. Therefore, important point you have to remember: at 4 degree Celsius, first point, volume of water is minimum. Volume of water is minimum, whereas density of water is maximum. You know, if on heating, if volume goes on increases, it is a normal process, happens in most of the substances. And as temperature increases, density goes on decreases, is common in most of the substances. But even if I take as temperature increases, volume decreases or density increases, even this happens continuously, then also we would have taken as a normal. But here what happens, up to 0 to 4 degree Celsius one behavior, above 4 degree Celsius another behavior. Means the water behaves from 0 to 4 degree Celsius and above 4 degree Celsius differently. This behavior is called anomalous behavior of water. But this anomalous behavior of water is a gift for most of the aquatic animals. Because of this anomalous behavior of water, most of the aquatic animals live in cold countries. Let's see how. See, as we know, say it is our liquid, you know, the body will loses its heat energy from the top. Body will loses heat energy from the top. Therefore, whenever this surface loses heat energy, then it becomes cool. When it is getting cool, its temperature goes on decreases. Hence, so top surface is cool as compared to bottom surface. So here, when temperature goes on decreases, I'll take two different sessions. When temperature is decreasing, say if it is less, say it is 10 degrees Celsius, 11, 12, 13 and so on. When it goes on gets cool, assume it becomes now 4 degrees Celsius, 5 degrees Celsius, 6 degrees Celsius, it is 7 degrees Celsius and so on. Now, top surface becomes less temperature now. Now at 4 degrees Celsius, density of the liquid is more. Since the density of this surface is more, this water start to sink and this bottom water will start to rise. Bottom means not complete. So this will come down and this will go up. Now what happens? Say now this becomes 5 degrees Celsius, it becomes 4 degrees Celsius. Now as further loss of heat energy, this becomes 4 degrees Celsius, it is also 4. Now this exchange will not take place. Then after that it becomes 3 degrees Celsius, then 2, then 1, then 0 degrees Celsius, like that. Once it becomes 0 degrees Celsius, further loss of heat, the surface becomes ice. But bottom water have temperature greater than 0 degrees Celsius. Hence, this remains in water for. Means in cold countries, even when surface water becomes ice, below that ice, the water is in liquid form. As a result of this, most of the aquatic animals live. Right. Okay. Means from this, you must remember two points. One, cooling of water takes place from surface. And formation of ice also takes place from the surface. Okay, so and how much time it takes to form certain thickness of ice, we'll discuss in next heading called calorimetry. Okay, after this anomalous expansion of water, now next is buoyancy, that is Archimedes' principle. Actually, I should discuss this in fluid mechanics, but since I have to take effect of temperature on buoyancy, that's why I'll take some brief background on buoyancy. Okay, see what is buoyancy and etc. Already you know from Archimedes' principle. Consider it is a container completely filled with a liquid. Completely filled with the liquid. Completely filled with the liquid. Okay, imagine some portion of the liquid. Okay, before going to that, imagine I want to put some object or some body, solid body, in this liquid. Suppose if I want to put this object, this body, in the liquid. But right now, this is completely filled with liquid. ಈ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಬಾಡಿಯನ್ನು ನಾನು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಫಿಲ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಸಮ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್. ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಬೇಕು, ಜಾಗ ಬೇಕು, ಆದರೆ ಎಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಜಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್. But right now, space is not there. Andre space create maadbeku. Space should be created. How to create is the question. Then simple, liquid must displace. Okay, so when this solid is immersed in the liquid, ee solid nanu liquid alli itteve antu helkodri tara, say ee tara ittidini antandre, if I keep this solid in the liquid, then the liquid which is present in this place, earlier e place alli liquid itto, earlier in this space there was a liquid, now this liquid is displaced. क्वेश्चन अराइजेस हाउ मच लिक्विड इज डिस्प्लेस्ड ಎಷ್ಟು ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಎಂಪ್ಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಷ್ಟು ಖಾಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಬಾಡಿ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಮರ್ಸ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ 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 ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಡ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ liquid volume of liquid displaced volume of liquid displaced is equal to volume of solid immersed volume of solid immersed volume of solid immersed okay this is one point again next this point you must remember carefully now the next imagine now come back now this container is filled with water or liquid you know assume this is a imaginary portion I'm not removing liquid from this portion ee portion the liquid remove martalla just nan imagine martta idena I imagine just imagine this portion of the liquid you know if I look at this portion of the liquid this portion has some mass this portion has some mass of the liquid You know this mass is attracted by the earth that force exerted by the earth on this portion is called its weight that is given by mg where m is a weight of the liquid present in this imaginary portion means on this imaginary portion gravitational force is acting you know when gravitational force is acting it should fall but this portion is not falling if this portion is not falling means according to mechanics equal and opposite forces might be acting now one force is correct that is mg acting down but where is another force who is exerting that another force is a question for that look at the figure who is there to exert the force on this imaginary portion answer no see when it is trying to fall the remaining portion of the liquid will push up hence I can say the remaining portion of the liquid means this portion the liquid which is present in this portion is exerting this equal and opposite force this equal and opposite force is nothing but up thrust this is called up thrust this is called up thrust thrust means normal forces up thrust okay how much is this up thrust is equal to mg because both must be equal and opposite okay fine so next means this is nothing but up thrust is equal to mg mg means weight of the liquid present in this imaginary portion now assume now in this place now I remove the water imagine you have removed the water from the place
Removed means mg removed, but not the remaining portion of the liquid. In this portion, now let us put a solid. Let us keep a solid. So whenever we put a solid, when I put a solid in the liquid, when solid is immersed in the liquid, this solid body, this body is also attracted by the earth towards its center. That is called weight. Weight is given by m into g. Here m is nothing but mass of the body. I will keep as a b, mass of the body. But don't get confused with the buoyancy. I'll call it as s only, solid body. But you know, already even when liquid was there, upthrust was acting. Even when body is immersed, this upthrust remains there. This upthrust is nothing but m into g, where m is the mass of the liquid which was present here. Right? Then on this body which is in the liquid, this is the body which is immersed in the liquid, like this. On this body which is immersed in the liquid, two forces are acting. One is gravitational force acting on the body. Another is the upthrust. This upthrust itself is called as buoyancy. Then net force acting on the body when immersed in the liquid. Net force acting on the body when immersed in the liquid. is called as the apparent weight of the liquid. That is W apparent. Apparent weight of the body. What is apparent weight? Apparent weight means net force. Net force means mass of the solid into g minus mass of the liquid into g. You know, how do you write mass? As you know, here somewhere I'll try to write. Density is equal to mass by volume, or volume can be written as density. Mass can be written as density into volume. Hence, apparent weight is equal to density of solid, volume of solid into g. Here density of liquid I'll put sigma into volume of liquid into g. As you know, volume of liquid displaced. Here it is volume of solid, it is volume of liquid which is displaced. I told here volume of liquid displaced equal to volume of solid immersed. Therefore, both volumes are same. Hence, apparent weight of the body, is equal to density of the solid body which is immersed minus density of the liquid in which body is immersed into volume of solid body which is immersed into acceleration due to gravity. So this is the apparent weight of a body when immersed in the liquid. This is called apparent weight. Right? Next, you know, in air its weight was m into g. When immersed in the liquid, in the same weight in air, this much is subtracted. Means when body is immersed in the liquid, the body loses its weight. How much weight it loses? How much weight it loses? Means minus. Minus means loses. How much it is losing? ml into g, which is equal to weight of the liquid which is displaced. Therefore, try to remember one more important point. So I think you have note, pause the screen and note down. So next one, another important point is the loss of weight of the body when immersed in the liquid. Loss of weight of body. Loss of weight of body is equal to weight of the liquid displaced. Weight of the liquid displaced. Okay. Note down. Pause the screen and note down. Okay, our next point is effect of temperature on density of liquid. Next heading, effect of temperature on density of liquid. Effect of temperature on density of liquid. Okay. See here, we know that whenever a liquid is taken in a container and when it is heated, then its volume of the liquid changes. You know, density is equal to mass divided by volume. You know, mass of the body remains constant. If when temperature increases and volume also increases, as volume increases, density of the liquid decreases. Then question is, what is the new density? Is the question, what is the new density? Okay, fine. It's very easy, right? So as we know, in air, before heating, right? before heating, say density is equal to mass divided by volume. Mass divided by volume.
See, whenever it is heated, density changes due to change in volume. So after heating,
so new density is equal to mass remains same, but new volume V dash. We know rho dash is equal to mass as it is. V means volume after rising the temperature, like final volume. This is equal to, we know that V is equal to V naught in bracket 1 plus gamma into delta T, where V naught is the initial volume. Today, here, initial volume means volume before heating. That is V in bracket 1 plus gamma into delta T. You know very well. So mass by volume. Mass by volume nothing but density of the liquid before heating. Okay. So therefore density of the liquid after heating is equal to density of the liquid before heating divided by 1 plus gamma into delta T, where gamma is coefficient of volume expansion of the liquid, and delta T is the rise in the temperature. Okay, pause the screen and note down. See, next point, effect of temperature on buoyancy. As you know, buoyancy means upthrust. As you know, when a solid is immersed in the liquid, the remaining portion of the liquid will exert upward force. That upward force exerted by the liquid on the solid immersed in the liquid is called buoyancy. Here, when temperature is increased, there is a change in the buoyancy. Let's see how it changes. See, here, I think not necessary to go in detail. We need only final expression. But even though I will try to derive. See, consider, you know, buoyancy. Buoyancy means, I said, upthrust. Means upward force exerted by the liquid on the solid which is immersed is equal to, you know, upthrust is nothing but mass of the liquid into acceleration due to gravity. Next. Buoyancy is equal to, mass can be written as density of liquid into volume of liquid which is displaced into G. You know, here V means volume of liquid which is displaced, volume of liquid displaced. Okay, next, see, when solid is, when it is heated, it is before heating. So after heating, so whenever it is heated, two things happen. One, volume of solid increases, V, volume of solid increases, whereas density of liquid, that is, decreases. So now new buoyancy is equal to, that is, F dash buoyancy. Buoyancy means same mass of the liquid into acceleration due to gravity. You know, it's the mass of the liquid displaced. So whether you heat or cool, there is no change in G. Okay, but mass of the liquid displaced may change. Next, F dash B is equal to, you know, mass, just now I wrote density of liquid. You know, density of the liquid changes, so I'm writing dash, and volume of the liquid displaced. Now question, whether volume of liquid displaced changes or remains same. As you know, volume of liquid displaced depends on volume of solid immersed. See, volume of liquid depends on volume of solid. See, after heating, volume of solid changes. Because of change in the volume of solid, volume of liquid displaced also changes. Hence, I'll write it as dash into G. Okay, I think just now in the previous heading I told, new density is nothing but original density divided by 1 plus gamma into delta T. This gamma of liquid. Okay, this is a volume of liquid which is displaced. But you know, volume of liquid displaced is equal to volume of solid immersed. V of liquid is equal to V of solid which is immersed. I asked you to note down. Therefore, it is nothing but final volume of the solid, means volume of the solid after heating. That can be written as you know, V is equal to V naught, 1 plus gamma into delta T, where V naught is the initial volume. Here, initial volume of the solid equal to initial volume of the liquid displaced. Hence, it is V into 1 plus gamma into delta T. Here it is for solid body. Right? Then it is G as it is. When you simplify, you know, F dash means buoyancy after heating is equal, you know, rho means sigma vg is nothing but fb into numerator 1 plus coefficient of volume expansion of solid which is immersed into delta T, divided by 1 plus coefficient of volume expansion of liquid into delta T. Right? So this is our final expression, or it is an expression for the buoyancy after heating. Pause the screen and note down. So next point is the calorimetry. I have to discuss with the calorimetry. This calorimetry is very, very, very important for examination point of view. That I will take in the next video.